So moving away from macOS is quite a big step. And it's not to do with the software that you can get to and things like that. Well, partly, depending on what you do. But a lot of it's to do with the world around it, the ecosystem that you buy into, because you've got the phone, you've got the laptop, there's one right here. And then when you get into it, it's really hard to get out. And actually part of the Omarchy, I think it's Omarchy or Omacube, I can't remember. It's one of DHH's like little stories on the information you get with the Omarchy about getting out of the services. I remember years ago, I had an iPhone, but I really wanted a Sony Xperia phone because it shot 4K or something like that. It had better video functionality on the Sony Xperia. And it meant I had to come out of the Apple world and switch to Google. And then all of a sudden, and it was, I was working on a really big job, and I sort of really needed to be in the right, you know, on the comms, and there were spreadsheets coming in, all this sort of business. But I wanted the filming functionality. So I switched to the Sony Xperia, and it was chaos, because all the things that I sort of took for granted and was really simple on my iPhone were, because I think the Google stuff wasn't quite as developed as it was. And it was just really hard because I'm still like over on the Mac. So it's a big step, and it's not so much about the technology, is it? I mean, you know, Samsung and Google and Android make amazing technology, but it's literally when you're in it, it's hard to get back out. So, you know, Omarchy, great. It's like a brilliant distribution of Arch, or not distribution. It's a remake of Arch that makes it easier for you to get access to such a powerful sort of setup. But if you want to move from Mac, you've really got to think it through how you do this. Now, somebody's already asked me a question about music software, and I'm going to do this hard, the music one. I'm going to do a music workout, how to like bolt in stuff to Reaper and what's the other one, Ardour, and see how we do that. My world's a bit easier. I mean, the first thing I do with any Linux distribution I ever get my hands on is literally write a script to install DaVinci Resolve, and that's like probably about 70% of my work done. So if I can get Resolve running, I'm good to go.